Hi there, welcome back to the channel. So today is about the three biggest mistakes I've seen most pivottable users make. Number one is not taking advantage of auto refresh on open. The biggest problem with pivottables is that you might report outdated data because you forget to refresh your pivottables. Now there is a setting that automatically refreshes your pivottable every time you open the file. Let me show you where that is. So over here in Excel, we have some campaign marketing data here. I'm just going to go ahead and quickly insert a pivottable on a new worksheet. Let's just add in some fields, add in campaign name and units sold. That setting is right here. Right mouse click, go to pivottable options, data, and place a check mark to refresh data when opening the file. So this makes sure that your pivottable refreshes every time you open the file. So if your colleagues go ahead and add data to this campaign here, when you open the file, this pivottable is going to refresh automatically. By the way, if you refresh your pivottables and new data doesn't show up, it's likely because you aren't using Excel tables as your source. Now, that's another common mistake that people make. What you could do to make sure that everything matches is to add validation checks to make sure that your pivottable data matches your source data. Now, I go in so much more detail about these topics in my newly launched course, Pivottable Essentials, but I'll tell you more about that later in the video. Next mistake is not using slicers to filter multiple pivottables. You see, if you're familiar with pivottables, you know that slicers are a great way to add interactivity to your reports and filter them. If you're not familiar with slicers, here's how you can quickly create one. So in this pivottable, we are summarizing the units sold by campaign name. And let's say I want to add a filter for the responsible person. I'm just going to right mouse click on this field and add it as a slicer. Now, these slicers are right here. I also have some slicer settings. I want to bring everyone to the same row. So let's just adjust this and bring our slicer and place it up here. Currently, this slicer is connected to this pivottable. So if I select Jesse, notice the values here change just to reflect the units sold for this campaign where Jesse is responsible. Now, Saul, I get these values. But this pivottable over here is not being filtered with the slicer. Let's say I want it to be filtered. I want it connected to this slicer. All I have to do is click on this pivottable, go to pivottable analyze, filter connections. That's my slicer. Place a check mark here and okay this. Now this pivottable is also connected to this slicer. Okay, so with one slicer, you can filter multiple pivottables. And by the way, you can also do this from the point of view of the slicer. If you click on the slicer, go to slicer in the menu, select report connections, you can see the different pivottables it's connected to. Now, one thing I've been itching to do since the beginning is get rid of these row labels and get proper labels here. So I'm quickly going to go to design and adjust the report layout to be in tabular form. I don't know what Microsoft was thinking to add row labels for that. I mean, who came up with that? Next mistake is wasting time writing VLOOKUPs or XLOOKUPs to bring over information from other tables so that you can create a single pivottable. The good news is there is a faster way without writing one single formula. So what I'm about to show you is the fastest way. Here we have our original data set. And let's say we've just received detailed information about the campaigns. Over here on this other sheet, I have this table called campaign details. It has a unique list of my campaigns, the campaign goal, whether it was to drive sales, to maximize customer loyalty, or increase brand awareness, the status of the campaign, the start date, and the region this campaign was run. So now what I need to do is to create a report based on campaign goal and status and show units sold. What a lot of people tend to do is go over here, add new columns, type VLOOKUPs or XLOOKUPs, and bring over this information from here and add it to this table. Well, you don't have to do that. Just leave your tables where they are Instead, go and insert a pivot table, but this time place a check mark to add this data to the data model. So we're going to okay this. Now we get a new pivot table inserted on a new sheet. Now currently, I just have my marketing data. So notice now I have this grouping enabled. What I'm working with right now is called a power pivot. So I can add in my units sold, but where is my campaign status or campaign goals? Well, I'm going to switch to all because in this view, I can see all tables that are in this workbook. So I have my campaign details here. I'm going to expand it. Now I'll just add in campaign goal to this. Now notice the numbers here aren't correct. They just show me the total sum. And I get a message here telling me that relationship between tables may be needed. I can create it on my own, or I can let Excel auto detect. Well, let Excel do the work. Now it is detecting. Notice the numbers changed. So it did find a relationship. I can just trust this, or I can go to manage relationships and see what Excel has done. That's the relationship. Let's go to edit this. We can see my first table that was marketing data. It chose the campaign name column and it has connected it to my second table, and that's the campaign name column. So it has created a relationship behind the scenes between these two tables. Now, if I switch to active, I have both of my tables here and I can make any type of report that I want. I'm going to add clicks from this marketing data table. And let's also add in the campaign status from here. So you can combine fields from multiple tables and create a single pivot table without writing any VLOOKUPs. Now, I want to keep this video short, but a bonus mistake is that people often tend to stick to the default look of pivot tables and they don't make the extra effort to clean things up. Like, take a look at this default pivot table. The difference between this and this is 1 minute. That extra effort makes a huge difference. I mean, think about it like this. Let's say you're dating and your potential girlfriend or boyfriend is going to come over for dinner. You don't have time to prepare anything. So you run across the street to the discount supermarket, like Hofer, Aldi, whatever that might be in your area, and you grab whatever. When they arrive, you're not going to put the food in the packaging in front of them, right? You're going to throw away that packaging. You don't want them to see that. You're going to take the food and present it nicely. Do that with your pivot tables. Your boss is going to love you. And you can achieve that with standard pivot table features and Excel features. Inside the course that we just released, which I mentioned earlier, Pivot Table Essentials Basics to Mastery, we already have a predefined template you can use together with tons of practice files. You also learn about advanced formatting options so that you have multiple different ways that you can make an impression. You also learn how to create interactive dashboards super fast using pivot tables as your basis. So basically, what the mistakes come down to is that people overlook powerful pivot table features and then they rely on inefficient workarounds. My aim with our new Pivot Table Essentials course is to save you time and frustration by showing you how to use pivot tables the right way, and also how to overcome problems that you are likely going to face along the way. You'll have a structured learning experience that takes you from basics to mastery. It includes lots of challenges to test your knowledge, because that's important. It also has lots of quizzes to reinforce what you learned. If you want to be fully confident in the way you use Excel and you use Excel pivot tables, check out the course, link to it is below. I'd be super happy to teach you this important skill from the ground up. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. And if you've come across other pivot table mistakes, share that with us below. And I'll catch you in the next video.